servers outside because there was no room inside. There's all these people that started coming in wagons and sugar cane trailers. They lay down there in the front and we started ministering to them. And this is the first time that Lily and I have an experience like this. All these people come to the front. And we started praying from the left to the right. And we came down from the platform, started praying for people. And as we were traveling, as we were walking, all those that were in Santeria, witchcraft, or zombies, or all that, without us laying hands, they will roll in the floor. We just go, oh, 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 wow, never seen this. They did the same thing. And then we went to the apartment to eat something, and they had this, like, 15-floor apartments for the sugarcane workers, and all controlled by the state. And we went inside and we were gonna eat and we started praying and the power of God came down. And a lady comes from the second, from the next floor. We were the third floor. It comes out and says, "What are you guys doing? I was in my room and I couldn't stand, I fell down. The power of God got me." She came and she was ministering. And it was just a beautiful outpouring of the Spirit, a beautiful blessing. The pastor shared something with me. He said, "Listen, thank God for this outpouring of the Holy Spirit. It's a very dry place. And when you travel, when you land in Cuba, we landed in the night. It was all dark. Because there's no oil. You feel that spirit of communism now is not too bad. Now there's open to tourists. But in those days when we went, we felt that heaviness of the oppression of communism." They had a little book, and you know, half kilo of you know, everything was Russian. That book. You take your book, they give you, what is it? You're entitled. A loaf of bread, so many grams of sugar, stuff like that. And the pastor said, "Listen, I want to share something with you." He said, after the Second World War, 1945, there was a ship that was in the harbor of Cuba. And it was Jewish people that were fleeing Europe, persecution in Europe, Hitler, all that. And they asked for asylum in Cuba. Families, children, they were in the ship, out in the sea, anchored, waiting for the Cuban government to allow them to land and work and bless and be successful, and you know, hardworking people. And the government rejected them, refused to allow the Jewish people flee from the oppression of Europe to land. And a few years later, we were taken over by communism. And we've been like this for 50 years. Because we rejected the blessing that came to our door. And God also rejected us. And notice this. There are many people that have been, many nations that have been liberated from communism. And communist, it's only China and it's terrible. You go over there, you see how it is. So the blessing is at your doorstep. You either decide you're going to accept the blessing or you're going to reject the blessing. The generation of Jacob, this is a Jacob generation. And it's not that it was a perfect generation, but see, it was a generation that seeked the Lord. And that was the blessed generation. From there comes a multiplication. Out of Jacob comes 12 children, which formed the 12 tribes of Israel. And among the 12 tribes come the tribe of Judah, which is the tribe where our King Jesus comes to reign with him. Who will reign with him? He who has clean hands and a pure heart, and who have not lifted up his soul to idols, nor sworn deceitfully. Verse 3 asks, who can ascend into the hill of the Lord? Or who may stand in his holy place? Let us conduct ourselves and walk according to God, the way God wants us to walk. The exaltation of Jesus. Verse 9. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is the King of glory? The Lord of hosts,